Now let's talk about the marking menu. Right click in the graphics area. This is the marking menu. Actually, the command surrounding the pointer is the marking menu, and the context menu is below it. There are two ways to use the marking menu. You can select commands from the menu, or you can use mouse gestures. So if you select the extrude command, for example, the command will open. Now I'm going to select the command using mouse gestures, but before I do, I want you to notice that the extrude command is up and to the right of my pointer. By the way, to close the menu, click in the center of the commands. A mouse gesture is a right drag in the direction of the command. You just saw that the extrude command is up and to the right at a 45 degree angle. So if you right drag in this direction, you'll evoke the command. To do this, press and hold your right mouse button down while you move your pointer up and to the right. This method is so fast that I'm going to use the click method when I evoke commands so that you can clearly see what I'm doing. What I want you to do is practice using mouse gestures to evoke commands. This way you see the location of the command in the lesson, so you'll know which direction to move your mouse gesture. After a little practice, you'll automatically know where the commands are. I'll do a mouse gesture one last time to show you the workflow of dynamically applying commands, and then from this point on, I'll use the click method. When you apply a mouse gesture, the command opens and the value input box is focused ready for input. So the next step is to either type the value or drag a manipulator. I prefer typing the value, so I'll enter 1 inch. If you want to give it draft, type the tab key and then enter the angle. To apply the command, you can type the enter key, click OK, or perform another mouse gesture. If you right-click at this time, you can see that you can apply the command by making a mouse gesture to the right. You can also cancel the command by making a mouse gesture to the left. So this is what the workflow of drawing the 1-inch pin would look like using mouse gestures. Now you can see why I'll use the click method, so that you can clearly see what I'm doing while you try to use mouse gestures. Mouse gestures are fast, but that doesn't mean you have to use them. You should use the interface method that best suits you.